Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. Find the coefficient of x to the power 19 in the polynomial expansion of this expression. Looks complicated if we know the following important result. It will be easy to solve this question. In general, look at the left-hand side. That's a polynomial. We are assuming n is a degree of polynomial. Set the polynomial equal to zero. That's the equation. This equation, we have the following result. Sum of the roots, that means sum of all the roots, zeros of this polynomial, equals negative an minus 1, this constant here, second leading constant, divided by leading constant an. Here we assume an is not 0. An is a degree of the polynomial. This is a very important result, very useful in solving problems. By the way, we also have this result. The product of the roots, all solutions of this equation equals a zero divided by the leading constants a n times negative one to the power n. N is the leading power, the degree of the polynomial. We are going to use this result to solve this question. If you know this result, this question is not that kind of difficult. Now in our case, how many items here? 20, right? From 1 to 20. 20, that means the highest power. N here should be 20. So this is A20. Next one is A19. What do we need to find? We want to find A19. We want to find A19. In the polynomial expansion of this one. What are those solutions, the roots for this polynomial? If we set the first equal to zero, we find x equals what? One, x equals one. X plus two equals zero, x equals negative two. X minus three equal to zero, x equals three. Then negative four, positive five, negative six, until 19, negative 20. Those are all roots for this polynomial. Or you call it all zeros, all zeros. Yeah. Our situation is this. The highest one, that's x to the power 20. A20, that's constants here. We want to find A19. If you want to expand this expression to this kind of format, it will take time, right? So it's difficult, not very easy to find A19. This way is a shortcut. Use the result. We can find the result quickly. So here, follow this formula. So here, negative A19 over A20 equals sum of all those roots. 1, negative 2, 3, negative 4, 19, negative 20. We group them for every two. How many groups? Totally we have 10. What's the number for this group? 1 minus 2 is negative 1. 3 minus 4 is negative 1. 19 minus 20 is negative 1. How many negative 1s here? Totally we have 10. So here, negative 1 times 10. Then we have negative A19 here. So here, we replace the A20 by 1. Why? Look at here. Consider the polynomial expansion of this is here. It's here. So this A20 is corresponding to the constants in front of A20. A20 means x times x times x times x until time x 20 times. What's the constant in front of each x? It's 1. 1 times 1, 1 times 1, 20 times, still 1. A20 is 1. A20 is 1. Simplify here. Negative cancel each other. We will have A19 equals 10. This is the answer. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.